Welcome back, guys. In this video, we're going to tackle a whole new concept, the idea of scientific notation. Now, a majority of you may remember scientific notation in algebra or from a course you've recently taken. Now, scientific notation is a way of changing very large or very small numbers into more manageable ones. Scientific notation is really a simple type of idea, but it's going to form the basis of all of our chemical calculations from this point on. Now, in order to understand scientific notation, you just have to remember the three components that make it up. So let's take a look at this number. We have 6.88 times 10 to the negative 12. We're going to say the first number, 6.88, is called the coefficient. And the thing about the coefficient is, the coefficient must be greater than or equal to 1, but less than 10. So that's the range that we're dealing with. We're going to say that the second number, which is the 10, is known as the base. And when it comes to scientific notation, the base is always 10. That's not ever going to change. Finally, we're going to say in 6.88 times 10 to the negative 12, the negative 12 number is known as our exponent. So those are the three portions that make up any scientific notation number that you're given. So just remember the guidelines for some of them and you'll be fine. Now, let's take those principles that we just talked about and apply them to these example questions now. Here we say convert the following numbers into scientific notation. So the first number we have is 377,000. Now, we know that our coefficient needs to be between 1 and 10. So we want the decimal point to be between this 3 and the 7. We also know that we have a decimal here at the very end, and we have to move it over so that it lands between that 3 and that 7. So we're going to say we move it over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, just realize we had to go to the left to get that decimal in the right position. So we went left, and anytime we go left, that means that our exponent will be a positive integer. It'll be a positive number. We had to move it over 5 spaces, so we're going to have 3.77 times 10 to the 5. Now, when I move the decimal over, those zeros at the end, we can drop those off and just simplify it to 3.77 times 10 to the 5. Remember, it's positive 5 because I had to go 5 spaces to the left. Let's take a look at the next one. In the next one, I have 0.000101. Again, we need our coefficient to be between 1 and 10. So we want the decimal to land between this 1 and this 0. Let's look at how many spaces we have to move it over. So we're going to move it over 1, 2, 3, 4 spaces to the right. So we're going to the right this time. Remember, every time we're going to the right, the exponent will be negative. Since we moved it over 4 spaces to the right, it's going to be 1.01 times 10 to the minus 4. For C, we have 707.82. Again, we want the coefficient to be between 1 and 10. So we want the decimal to fall between this 7 and this 0. So we're going to move it over 1, 2 spaces. We had to move it to the left. So remember, your exponent will be positive. So now it's 7.0782 times 10 to the 2 because we had to move it 2 spaces to the left. For D now, it's 161.00 times 10 to the 7. Remember, we need that coefficient to be between 1 and 10, so we need that decimal to be between this 1 and this 6. We have to move it over 1, 2 spaces to the left. When we move it to the left, it's positive. We moved it over 2 spaces, so it'll be a positive 2. But we already have an exponent there. The exponent is already plus 7. All you do is just add that plus 2 to that plus 7. So our new exponent at the end will be plus 9. So we have 1.61 times 10 to the 9. Now, finally, this last one. Again, We know the coefficient needs to be between 1 and 10. So we want it between the 6 and the 2. So let's move it over to the right. We have to move it over 2 spaces to the right. Remember, when we move it to the right, the exponent is going to be negative. We moved it over 2 spaces, so it's negative 2. To get the final exponent, remember, we started out with negative 9. Just add that negative 2 to that negative 9, and we'll have our final exponent calculation. It'll be negative 11. So our number becomes 6.28 times 10 to the negative 11. And basically, guys, that's scientific notation. Again, it's going to be imperative that you guys remember all the steps when it comes to scientific notation, because from this point on, your professor can easily ask you what's the scientific notation of your calculation after you performed all the necessary steps. So from this chapter and all the chapters that you're going to take in Chem 1 and in Chem 2, scientific notation is going to be a really important idea to follow and to maintain when dealing with very large or very small numbers. As long as you can remember all the concepts we went over, you'll be fine when it comes to scientific notation.